Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Steve Fury.
And I'm Lauren Grills.
And welcome to this week's show where we'll be talking about National Tree Day. We're also now on Instagram. We've got some more information on the Stand for Council campaign. There's some footpath works going on in Inverloch, but firstly, Lauren, we've had to remove an old cypress tree near the Rill Jetty after it was damaged by strong winds last week.
That's right, Steve. It's sad news. The tree was around 70 years old and suffered a significant split down its trunk. After being assessed by both council officers and an arborist, they decided the damage was so major that no amount of maintenance works like pruning or bracing the tree could save it.
The cypress was also in a popular area used by a lot of community members and visitors, as well as car parking. It was also at risk of falling on the historic Rill Jetty Shed, which is a heritage building valued by the community, and we recently spent some money on restoration works on it. So it's safe to say the tree wasn't safe at all, and while we do love our cypress trees, the risk of damage or injury meant that we had no choice but to remove it.
We'll now be working with the local community to find some suitable shade trees to replace the cypress. So stay tuned for more information in weeks to come. Speaking of trees, however, National Tree Day is fast approaching on the 31st of July, and it's your chance to get outside into nature and take part in the country's largest community tree planting, all while helping the local environment.
The Cape Willamai Coast Action Group is hosting an event this year, and they'll be planting in the Foreshore Reserve just south of the Willamai House development. Now, they'll be starting at 10 o'clock a.m. and meeting in the northern end of the Esplanade. Now, this planting continues on from last year's event, and this particular section of the foreshore was recently reclaimed after a property fence was realigned.
The planting will help increase biodiversity in the area, as the foreshore is a really important wildlife corridor that runs north to New Haven and south to the actual cave and further west down the coastline. So if you're looking for something to do, come and spend what will hopefully be a sunny Sunday morning getting your hands dirty and help the environment. For more information, you can visit treeday.planetark.org. Council has been delving into the world of social media lately with a Twitter account and a Facebook page, but as of last week, we're now on Instagram.
That's right, Lauren. For anyone who prefers the photographic side of social media, check out at Bass Coast Shire on Instagram. It's still only early days, but we'll be filling our page with scenic shots from around our beautiful Shire, as well as pics of projects we're working on and special events that are happening around Bass Coast. The emphasis is on quality photos that really show off the area, so it's also great for tourism. If you have a spectacular shot you'd like featured, don't forget to tag us on the pic on your own account. And don't forget, our handle is at Bass Coast Shire.
I'm already onto it, Steve, and following us on Instagram, so get onto it. Now, just another reminder that the local government elections are happening this year on the 22nd of October. Becoming a councillor is a great chance to influence the future direction of your local community. So if you're over 18 and you're on the electoral roll in Bass Coast, then chances are you're eligible to stand. If you're thinking about running or even just a little bit interested in learning more, there are Stand for Council events being held locally in August, which will give you the information that you need.
The first session will be held on Monday the 22nd of August at the Granfield Transaction Centre, then Tuesday the 23rd at the Cowes Cultural Centre, and the last session is in the Civic Centre Council Chamber here in North Aggie on Thursday the 25th of August. All these sessions run from 7 to 9pm, and if you need more information, contact us on the numbers at the end of the show or visit the campaign website standforcouncil.com.au.
Before we go, the Inverloch community may notice some works happening along Cashin Street next week and may be wondering what they're for. Council is building a new pathway link from 69 Cashin Street to Diane Place, including a new safe and compliant crossing to the Dixon Street footpath. These works will complete the final gap from the Opal Sea Haven aged care facility and connect with the existing path at Dixon Street.
Currently, residents have limited options to venture beyond the facility due to the location on Cashin Street, which has become a main thoroughfare for traffic, so it poses a potential risk to the elderly attempting to get to the Dixon Street footpath. Once these projects complete, Dixon Street residents will be able to walk, ride or scoot to Inverloch CBD entirely off-road.
This project is in response to customer requests received from local residents, and the 1.5 metre wide concrete path will also give residents along Cashin Street and nearby residential areas a safe off-road route to the local schools and shopping precinct.
Thanks, Lauren. That's it for this week, but as always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226278 or 03567 12211. You can also keep up to date with us on facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire, on Twitter at Bass Coast, and now at Instagram at Bass Coast Shire. We'll catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, bestcoast.vic.gov.au.